Hello, let us consider another system of equations and try to solve that one. So here we are taking this system of linear equation, x1 minus x3 equal to 0, minus x1 plus x2 plus x3 equal to minus 1, x1 minus x2 minus x3 equal to 0. The matrix representation of this system of equation will be like this, Ax equal to b, where A is the coefficient matrix, which is 1, 0, minus 1. Minus 1, 1, 1, 1, minus 1, minus 1, and x is x1, x2, x3, this column vector, and our b will be again a column vector, 0, minus 1, 0. So, our augmented matrix will be 1, 0, minus 1, minus 1, 1, 1, 1, minus 1, minus 1, and 0, minus 1, 0. That will be the last column. So, this is our augmented matrix. So, the first pivot element is 1, which is in the first column and first row. So, at first we make the element in the second row and first column to be 0. So, we will just add this R2 plus R1. So, it will give us the first row will remain unchanged. The second row will become 0. 1, this will again become 0 and this will be minus 1, and the third row will remain unchanged. Now we have to make this element to be 0. So what we have to do? We have to do R3 minus R1. So the first two rows will be same and the third row will become 0 minus 1 and this will again become 0. And this is 0. So, this is the third row. Now, the second row, the pivot element is this one, which is in the second column. And we have to make the, and this is already 1, so we don't have to do anything to make it pivot. And so, we have to make the element below that to be 0. So, we have to add R2 to R3. So, what we will get? We will get the first two rows will be same as we are not doing any row operations there. And the third row will become 0, 0, 0 and this will become minus 1. So, we get a matrix which is in reduced row echelon form. So, we will write it R x equal to B prime. So, where R is 1, 0, minus 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, x is x1, x2, x3 and our new B prime is 0, minus 1, minus 1. So, if we do that, we will get x1 minus x3 equal to 0, x2 equal to minus 1. And for the third one, we are getting 0 equal to minus 1, which is absurd. This is not possible. So, this system of equation has no solution. Because from the last row, we are getting 0 equal to minus 1, which is not possible. So, our system of equation from where we have started with has no solution. So, let us see the geometric representation of this system of linear equation. Okay, so the first plane look like this, which is given by x1 minus x3 equal to 0. So, it will look like this. So, this is the representation of the first equation. The representation of the second equation is this plane, which is minus x1 plus x2 plus x3 equal to minus 1. So, this is the second plane. The third equation is x1 minus x2 minus x3 equal to 0. So, it will pass through origin and this is the third plane. So, if we consider the first and the second plane, we will see that they will intersect at a straight line, which is given by this straight line. Now, if we see the first and the third equation, they will again intersect in another straight line. So this will be the straight line where they are intersecting. So the first and third equation have infinite number of solution, and the first and second equation also have infinite number of solution. But when we considering three planes together, we can see the solutions, which are two straight lines, they are basically parallel to each other and they are not meeting at anywhere because they are parallel. So these three planes are not meeting at any point. I mean, there is not any point where all these three planes are intersecting each other. So this three equation has no solution. Thank you.